This is Paul Carcaterra with ESPN and Cascade Maverick Lacrosse. 2015 was an incredible year. We saw the first team west of Chapel Hill, North Carolina, win a national championship with the Denver Pioneers. 2016, everyone's talking Denver. Everyone's talking Notre Dame. Everyone's talking Duke. But there are five or six teams that I think can challenge for a national championship. And the top 10, I'm rolling them out right now. Number 10, the Loyola Greyhounds. Just have to find a way to win the close games. In 2015, 6 one-goal losses. Number 9, Brown. Everyone loves the up-tempo offense that Lars Tiffany has up in Providence, Rhode Island. Number 8, the Yale Bulldogs. All they've done is win 3 of the last 4 Ivy League championships. Number 7, the Syracuse Orange. Don't count them out. They lost 5 of their top 6 scorers from a year ago, but they have all the ingredients for a championship team because they have Warren Hill in the cage, who has international experience with Team Iroquois. He played incredible in the fall. They have Ben Williams, one of the top 2 faceoff men in all of college lacrosse that can control tempo. And they also had a gift in the offseason, transfer from UMass, Nick Mariano. The Minutemen leading scorer his freshman and his sophomore year. Look for him to have a big impact. Number 6, the Johns Hopkins Blue Jays. If you asked me in the summer, I thought this was a surefire top 4 team. But in the offseason, midfield losses. Number 5, the Virginia Cavaliers. Can they get back to their dominant form? I think they can. James Pinnell comes back after a blown ACL in 2015. They need him to be the man at attack. And I love the kind of versatility they have with guys like Zed Williams and Greg Kaholin. Guys who can play attack and midfield. They dodge from the wings. They can go up top and behind. So they're an unpredictable offense for offensive coordinator Mark Van Arsdale. You got a goalie in Matt Barrett who played great as a sophomore last year, but their team defense has always been the big question. And Tanner Scales was injured a year ago. He might be one of the top shutdown defenders from a one-on-one standpoint in all of college lacrosse. Number 4, the Duke Blue Devils. Well, they have the most polarizing figure in all of college lacrosse in regards to Miles Jones. The 6'4" midfielder is a battering ram with incredible stick skills. He can pass, he can shoot, and he understands offense at another level. His line mate, Deemer Class, is a perfect complement to Jones' playmaking ability because he's a great step-down shooter. I think the big questions for Duke, can their defense continue to grow? They were very young a year ago and were exposed many of times. And on the attack, if Case Mathias can play at an All-American type level, if he is that presence behind, and then Deemer Class and Miles Jones up top with Justin Gutterding shooting from the left-hand side, this offense will be virtually impossible to stop. Number 3, the Maryland Terrapins. How can you bet against Maryland? They've been to 4 of the last 5 Final Fours behind John Tillman, and this coach knows how to win. He has the formula to get the championship weekend. He has a shutdown defense, a team that really prohibits goal scorers from a dodging standpoint to beat them. Kevin Conry, their defensive coordinator, has done an exceptional job in that regards. And they have the best goalie in the country in Kyle Bernlohr, first team All-American a year ago. Matt Rambo on the offense, he's now a junior. He needs to be the undisputed leader of this offense. We know what he can do from a goal scoring standpoint. I think he needs to up his assist totals and get some of the teammates involved. Henry West is a great senior midfielder for them. He's a north-south dodger who puts pressure on defenses, but this offense, very difficult to defend because of the versatility and the depth. Number 2, the Notre Dame Fighting Irish. So close from winning national championships the last 6 years. Could this be the luck of the Irish in their year in 2016? Well, they have every level of the field covered in regards to a superstar, Matt Cavanaugh. An All-American attackman, the lefty crashes the cage and puts so much pressure on opposing teams' defense because of the way that he goes to the cage, throws his body around, and is a big-time clutch performer. Sergio Perkovic, we've seen what he's done in the past in regards to his clutch performances. This kid outside of Miles Jones, I think, is clearly the best midfielder in all of college lacrosse. My questions for the Irish, their top 5 or 6 players are incredible. Do they have players 7 through 15 that could play somewhat at the level of those superstars? My number 1 team, the Denver Pioneers, defending national champs. Man alive, I love this offense. Connor Cannizzaro, the junior attackman, who had 90 points a year ago. If it's not Miles Jones for the Tuerton, I think it's Cannizzaro. His ability to break defenses down with his quickness He's about as quick as Jordan Wolf was for Duke in their title run in 2014. Cannizzaro is the quarterback. He distributes the ball with great passes, and he's got incredible finishers with guys like Zach Miller and Tyler Pace. If they need the ball, not a problem. They have the best faceoff man from a year ago in the country. Last year as a freshman, Trevor Baptiste was a first-team All-American. He was make it, take it for this offense. He fed the beast in terms of giving them possessions, putting so much pressure on opposing teams' defenses. Defensively, the big question is, who replaces Ryan LaPlante? It's a three-way battle right now in the preseason for the Pioneers. That's a wrap on the 2016 preseason Top 10. It's going to be an incredible season. Catch me up in the box for ESPN or on the field. And for all your latest and greatest Maverick and Cascade gear, check out lax.com. Also, check out lax.com for great highlights throughout the course of the 2016 season.